How to use output properties of the component in PowerApp. Hi, this is Krupali from Know-How Academy. So let me tell you what you are going to learn in this video. I have designed one screen. In that, when I enter number 1 and number 2, and when I click on the sum button, it will give me the answer. Now, initially it looks very simple, but I have done using a component. Now, what is this? This is a component which I designed. When I click on the sum button, a component output property will return the answer to the PowerApp canvas screen. So how to do that? So for that, what you need to do? So you need to first design a component like this. So let me take one component. So component one, and let me rename it as a sum. Okay, we are doing some. You can design your own calculator after learning the input and output property. Okay, so let me take one text box. Text input 1, text input 2. So I'm taking two text box for taking two numbers. And then I'm taking button. And let me fix the properties of this. Okay, so I have designed a component screen which take two numbers from the user, and when I click on the sum button, it will perform the summation of the two numbers. So let me write a code on sum button. So I'm using a value function which will convert text into the value. So txt number 1 dot text plus value txt number 2 dot text. Now let me save and add this component into the PowerApp screen. So let me design a screen. Okay, and in this screen I'm taking a component which I have taken, that is sum. So component is ready. Now let me do one thing. Let me write a value inside that, so 10, 20, and when I click on the sum, it should do the sum. But here it performed the sum, but it is not displaying the answer. Why? Because whatever value we have taken inside that, where we should print it. So let me take one label here in the screen and let me print the answer here. Answer is, okay. And I want to display the answer of whatever the value we have taken. But let's say when we write here the answer, or let's say here when we try to access the control which is there inside a component, so txt number 1 text box you cannot see. So what we can do here, we will process that thing inside a component and we will return the answer. Whatever the answer of that two text box, we will give that answer to the here. So how we can do that? So for that, we need to take output property of that. So how can we take output property? So click on the component screen, and here in new custom property, you need to take a output property. Now let's say here, output property name, I'm giving as an answer. And here it's a custom property, and this time I'm making it as an output property. And it will return the answer. So I'm taking a data type as a number. And click on create. So answer is created. Now what I need to do, if I write this, it will not store answer anywhere. So what I will do, I will store this answer in the variable. So how can I do that? So to do this, I will use set and then the name of the variable, let's say answer, and here I'm writing value inside that. So this is the summation I'm doing it. Okay, and let me complete the bracket. So whatever the value or whatever the sum is there, it will assign into this answer variable. Let me click, let me save. And whatever the value of that answer, I want to give to the output property. So where I can find output property? So you can find output property here in the same drop down list where you are finding the input property. So we have already created one property. The name of the property is answer, and which is type of output property. So you can see here. Okay, and here select the output property, and here I'm writing the variable name ANS, which I have created. So when I click on the sum button, it will assign the value, whatever the value is there in that, and then it will assign that value to the output property. Let me save it. Okay, so let me add this component to the screen. I have already added. So what I need to do, click on that, and here we need to write the output property of this component, and we know our component name is sum. Okay, and here the component name is sum, and here it is showing sum 1. Let me just cut it and edit again, so it will not create any confusion. Custom and sum. Okay, here again I am adding, and here whatever the output is there, I need to write here. So here it is renaming the component name, it's because of sum. One, maybe it's already there in some other screen, so that's why it is creating a rename it sum underscore one. But don't worry, we will keep it as a sum one. Okay, and here we need to write the output property. So how we can access the output property? So first of all, we need to write the name of the component, and when we press the dot, you will able to see the input and output property both. We have created answer as the output property, and you can read it or you can select it. Okay, let me click on save and run it, and let me add the number, that is 30, then 40. So you can see the answer is there. So what actually we have done? So when we are passing the value inside the text box, so what component will do? When you click on the sum button, it will set the value inside the answer variable, and the answer variable value we have already assigned to the component property answer to this. And here in the screen, when we are displaying or printing the answer, we are accessing that component, then we need to write dot, and we can access the property whatever we have created, whether it is an input property or whether it is an output property. So here we have selected the output property, so it is giving the answer. An input property means from screen we are passing value inside the component, and using the output property from the component we are taking the value. Now I think you are clear that how to use output properties of the component. Thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as a source of your IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate to the tech world. If you have any question, do not feel hesitate to reach out to us. Stay curious and keep learning.